Do you want to use OpenCode in your GitHub repo? If so, this video is for you. We're going to look at how you can connect OpenCode to GitHub. Let's jump straight in. So this is a new feature that just came out recently. You can do this for GitHub or GitLab. If you want the GitLab documentation, just hit there. But we're going to be focusing on the GitHub installation. So pretty much you can use OpenCode to look at different issues, fix and implement code. It's pretty much secure. And to get started, it's very simple. All you do is OpenCode GitHub install, and it will run through the features. We'll jump into that now. All right, without further ado, let's just jump straight to the code. So I'm just gonna run OpenCode GitHub install, and this will prompt the whole thing. This will put us into the wizard to install OpenCode agent to our GitHub repository. I'm gonna go install. I'm gonna say where I wanna install. I'm gonna do it my local, and then I'm only gonna select this repo. And this is OpenCode. OpenCode agents, perfect. And now I'm installing this. Okay, so we've connected OpenCode to our GitHub, but we need to do one more last thing. We need to select the model provider. So I'm gonna select the model. I'm gonna select Claude 4 Sonnet. It's gonna tell me I need to put this Anthropic key. Where you go do this in the repo is essentially, it gives you the instructions here. It tells you to commit the current workflow, which it just added here, so we can have a quick look at that. So we can see it literally is looking for the slash commands slash OC or slash open code. With that, it'll call open code agent on the GitHub. It's saying what the run is, and it's using the Anthropic key, as we can see there, and it's using the model as we specified. But at the moment, our GitHub repo doesn't have this because we have to commit it up, obviously. Also, we need to set our secret key. All right, so how do we actually set the secret key? All right, so let's go set the secret key quick. So just jumping to our, this is the repo I'm sitting on. I'm just gonna go settings here. And then in settings, we will see there's this whole secrets and variables here. I'm gonna click here, there's code space and actions. As it's a workflow, I'm gonna go into actions. And in actions, I'm literally gonna just add a new secret. I'm going to put my secret name. I'm going to put the API secret in now. So just, I'm going to stop here and I'll be back in a bit. All right, I'm back. So I've added my Anthropic secret key. So let's just go back to the code. I'm going to commit this up. So we've got that change. Just quickly, I was working in a feature branch here. If you actually wanted to work on your main GitHub issue, I think you need to push it into your main branch. I could not get working until I pushed it from my feature branch to my main branch. So that's just one thing to note. Coming straight back into it. I've just created a new issue here that I just want to change one of the features on the dashboard. I'm just gonna go OC here and nothing will pop up. And I'm just gonna say explain this issue and I'll see the result. And we should see OpenCode will be pulled into here and we'll try fix this issue. We'll just wait a few seconds. Just gonna reload just to see. We can see OpenCode is working on the issue right there. All right, and we can see OpenCode did the explanation and how we could resolve this issue, and it was quite detailed. So this is just using the standard automatic OpenCode feature. I do wanna jump into what code review would look like. Quickly, I've got this OpenCode agent folder here, and I've got reviewer. And you can see here it's very simple. I just asked for security concerns. It's very basic. I could add very specific security concerns here. I'm literally using this reviewer in my code review. How I'm doing that is if I'm going to my PR, for example, I can go /OC and then the at symbol, then target the agent that I've specified. And because the folder name was reviewer, I just go at reviewer. And it will spin up an instance of OpenCode agent, and it will run and it'll come back with these recommendations. As you can see, it kind of looked at the new workflow I put in, assessment, good practice, and overall rating. Gave me a 5-star. Great. What's nice is you can actually come to actions here and actually make sure that it is using the right one. So we can see here these two different ones that ran, one worked and one didn't. Let's just look at the one that did. What's nice is we can actually go into the OpenCode here and see how did it instantiate. How do I know that it's actually using the review agent? I can come down here and actually make sure it's connecting to the review agent. And we can see here, it says, I'll launch the review agent to analyze this pull request for you. That's great. So it means it's just, it uses the review agent for us. And that's how we get this security assessment that we saw earlier. I hope you found this video useful, a quick guide on how to connect GitHub to OpenCode. And I'd love to hear your thoughts on what I should display next. I'm really trying to build this channel to work with AI tools and AI development. I don't always get enough time to get around to everything. And I don't think some of the formats work good for YouTube. So I'd really like to know what you guys are struggling with. I definitely want to dive a bit more into detail in the coming videos on this channel. Anyway, please drop a comment down below and I will talk to you there. Cheers.